friends, first let me introduce myself. Myself Soumya and I am from ENS Medical Academy. Today I am here to give you a clear-cut explanation about cell cycle and cell division. So friends, are you aware that all organisms, even the largest, start their life from a single cell? Now we will discuss about how the cell division occurs, how the cell divides and what are the steps involved in it, and how the daughter cells are formed. Before going to our discussion, keep a view on the topics we are going to discuss. The first topic is cell cycle and the next topic is phases of cell cycle. Our first topic is cell cycle. Cell cycle is nothing but cell division, which is very important to all organisms. During cell division, DNA replication, karyogenesis and cytokinesis are occurring in sequence to ensure the correct division. Events during cell division are DNA replication, synthesis of cell organelles and distribution of DNA and cell organelles into the daughter cells. This cycle involves in several steps. And next, our next topic is phases of cell cycle. Phases of cell cycle can vary from organism to organism and from cell type to cell type. A typical eukaryotic cell, for example, human cells, divides once in approximately 24 hours, while an E. coli cell can progress through cell cycle in only about 20 minutes, while an yeast cell can progress through cell cycle hardly about 90 minutes. And next, our phase of cell cycle is divided into two phases, that is the interphase and M phase. First, interphase. It is a non-apparent phase and it occurs in between two successive cell divisions. Anciently, it is considered as a resting phase, but now it is considered as a growing phase. Interphase lasts about more than 95% of the total duration of the cell cycle, and in a human cell, it lasts about 23 hours. And interphase is further divided into G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase and G0 phase. Friends, the previous sneak peek from this area is the sequence of the phase of cell cycle, that is G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase, G0 phase and M phase. First, G1 phase. G1 phase is also called as growth phase. Because the cell growth continuously occurs in this phase, DNA and RNA synthesis occurs in this phase. And friends, note this point, it is the largest subphase. If we see this diagram, the representation of the phase of cell cycle, here we clearly observe that the G1 phase of interphase is the largest subphase. And next, S phase. S phase is also called as synthesis phase. It occurs in between G1 phase and G2 phase. The main event in this phase is the replication of DNA. That means the amount of DNA per cell doubles. If the initial amount of DNA is denoted as 2C, then it increases to 4C after the S phase. And next, G2 phase. G2 phase is also called as gap 2 phase. In this phase also, the cell growth continuously occurs. And division of cell organelles, example mitochondria and plastids, occurs in this phase. And some animals lost their ability to divide, and many cells divide occasionally as needed to replace the cells during cell death or an injury. So that cells that are not able to divide further enter into an inactive state called the quiescent state, that is none other than G0 phase. And next, M phase. M phase is divided into mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis is also called as equational division. Friends, we all know about mitosis commonly, and some students feel a dip of difficulty in meiosis process. So today I will give you a clear explanation about meiosis. Today my point of view is about meiosis, so please concentrate on this. Meiosis is further divided into interphase, meiosis 1, interkinesis and meiosis 2. First, interphase. As we discussed above about interphase, the same events occurs in this phase. And next, meiosis 1. Meiosis 1 includes karyogenesis and cytokinesis. And karyogenesis is divided into prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. Prophase 1. Prophase 1 of meiosis is typically longer when compared to the prophase of mitosis. Prophase 1 contains 5 subphases, that is eptotin, zygotin, pagotin, diplotin and digynesis. Friends, do you feel any difficult to remember the correct sequence? Don't worry, I will give you a keyword. And the keyword is lazy people, dip dye, that is leptotin, zygotin, pagotin, diplotin and digynesis. Friends, I repeat again, lazy people diptyque, that is leprotein, zygotin, pyrrotin, diplotin and diagnosis. With this you can easily remember the sequence of prophase 1. And our first phase is leprotein. During leprotein stage, the condensation or compaction of chromosomes occurs and there is a clear visibility of chromosomes. And during this phase, each chromosome is two chromatids. Friends, this whole is called chromosome and these two are called chromatids and this is called centromere. And during this phase, we can clearly observe the chromosome structure. And next, the second phase is zygoting. During this stage, the chromosome starts pairing and the association is called synapsis and forms a complex structure called synaptonemal complex. Here we represent the chromosomes as bivalent chromosomes and the tetrads as and the chromatids as tetrads. Here we can represent the chromosome number as 2n equal to 4. And the third stage is pyrrotin. When compared to the first two stages, pyrrotin is a typically larger stage of prophase 1. And during this stage, the chromosome start crossing over occurs between two homologous non-sister chromatids. Friends, these two are called sister chromatids and these two are called non-sister chromatids. You can clearly observe in this diagram the crossing over occurs between two homologous non-sister chromatids. And crossing over occurs between non-sister chromatids and crossing over is mediated by an enzyme called recombinase. Here the main phase is the formation of recombination nodule. And here chiasmata formation occurs, and chiasmata means the X-shaped structure. And the next stage is diploidy stage. During this stage, the chromosomes get separated except the zone of crossing over. We can observe that the chromosomes are separated except the zone of crossing over. And next stage is diagenesis. During this stage, the nuclear membrane, nucleolus disappears. And the chromosomes get separated but attached only at their tips. You can observe this diagram. The chromosomes are only attached at their tips. Here also we represent the chromosome number as 2n equal to 4. And by the end of the prophase, so friends, we feel difficult to remember it in a theoretical way. So I'll give you a technique to remember easily. Then the technique is, during leprotein stage, the chromosomes are clearly visible. See my hands carefully. I'll give you an easy way. And during leprotein stage, the chromosomes are clearly visible. And during zygotin stage, the chromosome starts pairing and the crossing over pairing occurs between two homologous non-sister chromatids. And during pyrrotin stage, the crossing over occurs between two non-sister chromatids. And during diploidy stage, the chromosomes get separated except the zone of crossing over. And last, diagenesis, the chromosomes get divided except the site of tips. The chromosomes attached only at their tips. With this technique, you can easily remember the events occurs in the prophase 1. And the second stage of meiosis 1 is metaphase. The complete disintegration of the nuclear envelope marks the start of the second phase of the meiosis 1 is called metaphase. During this phase, the chromosomes, the bivalent chromosomes align on the equator, that is this plate, equator plate, that is metaphase plate. And here you can see that the centromeres moves towards poles and the chromosomes are present at the center. Here we represent the chromosome number as 2n equal to 4. And after completion of metaphase, and next phase is anaphase. And during this phase, the chromosomes align on the equatorial plate, that is the metaphase plate, get divided and the chromosomes move to their respective poles. Here we can clearly observe that the chromosomes get divided and move to their respective poles. Here the contraction of spindle fibers occurs. With the help of the spindle fibers, the chromosomes get separated. Here we clearly observe that the chromosome number is reduced to half. Here we represent the chromosome as 2n equal to 4, but here we represent as n equal to 2 and n equal to 2. That means the chromosomes get separated and the chromosome number reduced to half. And the last stage of meiosis 1 is telophase. And during this phase, the decondensation of chromosomes occurs. That means the chromosomes lost their ability. You can observe that the chromosomes lost their ability and the structure of the chromosome is not visible here. And here also the chromosome number reduced to half. And nuclear membrane and nucleolus, as they disappeared in this phase, get reformed in this phase. And next, cytokinesis. During this phase, the cell itself get divided into two daughter cells. That is first daughter cell, this is second daughter cell. Here the haploid, the daughter cells are haploid in nature, that is n equal to 2. And by the end of meiosis 2, the result is the formation of two haploid set of daughter cells. And after cytokinesis, the immediate process is meiosis 2. In contrast to meiosis 1, meiosis 2 is similar to mitosis. The same events occurs in this phase. And next, after meiosis 2, cytokinesis occurs. In this phase also, the cell itself get divided and forms four haploid set of chromosomes. The ultimate result of meiosis is the formation of haploid chromosomes, that is four haploid set of daughter cells. By the end of this, we can complete the meiosis topic. And first, let's see this table. If you by heart this table, you can easily answer any numerical questions. So please concentrate on this table. And in this table, we represent the chromosomes and chromatids number. Here, we represent the chromosomes as 2n equal to 4. That means we are taking in 4 chromosomes. And during the G1 phase, the chromosomes are 4 and the chromatids are 4. And during S phase also, the chromosomes are 4 and chromatids becomes 8. Why? Because in the S phase, the DNA replication occurs, so the chromatids numbers change to 8. And next, during G2 phase also, the chromosomes are represented as 4 and the chromatids 8. And during prophase 1 also, we can observe that the chromosomes are 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 and the chromatids are 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And during metaphase also, we can observe this diagram. The chromosomes are 4 and the chromatids are 8. And during the anaphase 1, that is this phase, the chromosomes get separated. That means the chromosome number reduced to half, and this represents two chromosomes here and two chromosomes here. Two, that pole and two, this pole. And next, here chromatids, 1, 2, 3, 4, same. This pole 4 chromatids and this pole 4 chromatids. And during telophase, as we observe this diagram, two chromosomes upper side and two chromosomes lower side, and same as the chromatids. And next, prophase 2. We observe the diagram prophase 2. Here two chromosomes, here two chromosomes, and there 4 chromatids and here 4 chromatids. And the same as metaphase 2 and anaphase 2. We can clearly observe in this phase, the chromatids get separated. During anaphase 1, the chromosomes get separated, and during anaphase 2, the chromatids get separated. So we represent the chromatids as 2, 2 and 2, 2. Observe this, there 4 chromosomes, here 4 chromosomes, that means upper side four, 2 chromatids, below 2 chromatids, and here 2 chromatids and here 2 chromatids. And the same occurs in the telophase 2. And we can say that each cell has 2 chromosomes and 2 chromatids. So friends, hope you enjoy the lesson and practice well for your exam. And Vyans Medical Academy wishes you very all the best for your NEET 2020, and may all your dreams come true. Thank you.